you are aware, we are here to celebrate the Milad of the Prophet Sallallahu, so everyone should be smiling. Yet this is not an ordinary event. If it wasn't for this day, we would have nothing. We would have no Quran, no deen. We wouldn't recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should be happy. And I would like to see if everyone is happy by raising your hand with takbir. At-takbir! At-takbir! Inshallah, short time, and I would like to straight away jump into the topic which I'd like to share with you. We are in a time where there's a lot of fitna and a lot of confusion due to lack of knowledge, due to lack of understanding, due to people not studying the Quran properly, due to people not studying the Quran with the love, the glasses of love, due to people not studying the ahadith with the glasses of love. Due to lack of knowledge, there is a lot of misconception. And then people accuse us, who are the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the majority of the Muslims, the Ahlul Sunnah, we get accused that we exceed the limits in the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the topic for tonight, to this evening, is: are we exceeding the limits in the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? This is a question, and this is a case which I put in front of you. And today, inshallah, within the next 15 to 20 minutes, you will decide whether the case is correct. Are we exceeding the limits? Or should we exceed the limits? Or did the Sahaba exceed the limits in the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So it is important to see whether we are exceeding the limits, or did the Sahaba, who were the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who were closer to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are the one who were in the company of Rasulullah, they were the one who saw the blessed face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were the one who saw the blessed hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were the one who saw the blessed walking of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Were they exceeding the limits, or are we exceeding the limits by celebrating Milad? So let's have a comparison, inshallah. Let's look at what did the Sahaba do? Yeah, what did the companions do to show their love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? There's a famous hadith in Sahih Bukhari. I'm quoting hadith which are Sahih, so there should be no doubt about it. That Urwa, before he accepted Islam, when he came as an ambassador from the Kuffar, he came for a dialogue with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he spent time in the company of the companions and Rasulullah. So he stayed and he observed the companion. And when he went back to the Kufar al Makkah, he said that, "I swear by Allah, I have been to many kingdoms. I have been to the sea kingdom of Caesar. I have been to the kingdom of Najashi. But what I saw in the company of Rasulullah, in the kingdom of Sina Rasulullah, I did not see anywhere else." What did he see? He saw that the companions had so much love that they did different things. For example, the hadith says that when Rasulullah ﷺ would want to get rid of his blessed saliva, our saliva contained germs. But when he wanted to get rid of his blessed saliva, the Sahaba would make sure they had none on their hands. And they would wipe it on each of their hands. And they would wipe it on their face. Is this not exceeding the limits of the love? Are we exceeding limits by loving Rasulullah, by celebrating Milad? Or did the Sahaba exceed the limits by collecting the blessed saliva? And the hadith continues that when the Prophet would do wudu water and the remaining water for wudu, the Sahaba would fight over it. The hadith says that they would yaqtatiluna ala wudu'ihi. They would fight over the wudu water. And if they did not get any wudu water, they would touch the other companions just so that they can take the barakah. Is that not exceeding the limits of the love of Rasulullah? Are we exceeding the limits by celebrating the Milad of the Prophet? Another hadith in Sahih Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to have his hair shaven, a haircut with the barbers. And the hadith says that the Sahaba wa ataha bihi ashabuhu, the companions of the Prophet, the lovers of the Prophet, they used to circumambulate around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, making sure not a single blessed hair, and not a single blessed hair of the Prophet would fall on the floor. Is that not exceeding the limits? Are we exceeding the limits by celebrating Milad? And then another hadith in Sahih Bukhari again, the companion says that we received a hair from Sayyidina Anas and from the family of Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu. We received the hair of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he tells the other companion that this hair,
The other companion says to the person who's got the hair that if I have this hair, this companion is saying that if I have this hair, then that hair would be beloved to me more than anything in this world. That one piece of hair of Rasulullah, so Rasulullah would be blessed and beloved to me than the whole wide world and everything that's inside the world. Is that not exceeding the limits of the love of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? We all know that. Umm Sulaym, when she came home and found out Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, again hadith of Sahih Muslim, I'm quoting you authentic hadith that no one can deny. Umm Sulaym, when she came home and found that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was sleeping on the bed, which was made out of leather. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, due to the heatness, he was sweating. But Rasulullah was asleep. And that sweat had gathered on the leather bed in one area. And Umm Sulaym, what she started to do? She started to collect, she got a bottle, and she started to collect the blessed sweat of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Because the sweat of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was not like ordinary sweat. The sweat of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam smelled like beautiful and musk. And she started to collect the blessed sweat. The Prophet woke up and she said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, Umm Sulaym, what are you doing? She said, I am collecting this blessed sweat of yours for the barakah of my children. The Prophet said, you are doing correct. He did not say, what are you doing, this bidah? I didn't tell you to do this. Prophet did not say that. He said, you are doing correct. Do that, continue with that. So are we exceeding the limits by celebrating Milad? Or the companions exceeding the limits by collecting the blessed sweat of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Interesting. Put your hands if you all been to Madinah Park. So mashallah, a good handful of people. Those people who have been to Madinah Park must have gone to the Riyadh al-Jannah. And when you go to Riyadh al-Jannah where Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to lead the prayer, and I want to pay attention. So pretend this is the Qibla towards that direction. This is the Riyadh al-Jannah. The house of Rasulullah is on the left hand side. And Imam is reading the prayer. The house of the Prophet is on the left hand side. Keep that vision in mind. The hadith of Sahih Bukhari is that when Rasulullah, when he was ill, towards the last end time of his physical life, when he was ill, then he did not come out to pray for 3 days. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq was leading the prayer. Hadith of Sahih Bukhari was leading the prayer. And after 3 days, that's 5, 10, 15 prayers. Those companions who used to see the blessed face of Rasulullah every day, 5 times a day in prayer, they hadn't seen Rasulullah for 3 days, for 15 prayers. And when Abu Bakr Siddiq was leading the prayer, and he said it was Yom Ithnain, it was Monday, Sayyidina Rasulullah, after 3 days, on left hand side, where the Abu Bakr is leading the prayer, the companions are inside prayer. The hadith says, "Hum safufun fi salah." They are in prayer. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam lifts the curtain. And who's explaining this? The companion, who was obviously in the prayer as well. He says that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam lifted the curtain. فَكَشَفَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ سِتْرَ الرُّجْرَةِ يَنْزُرُ إِلَيْنَا وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ. He says that the Prophet lifted the curtains and he was looking towards us, and he was standing. And when he was standing, أَنَّ وَجْهَهُ وَرَقَةُ مُصْحَفٍ. The companions are describing the face of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They are in the prayer, but they are describing the face of Rasulullah, which is far left. And what did they see? They said that the Quran, when the Prophet came, as he lifted the curtains, it was as if the Quran had opened. And when that happened, they also said, "Thumma tabassama." I.e. the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam smiling. Now the people are in prayer. Rasulullah sitting on the far left. He was smiling. And then the companion says, listen to these words. فَهَمَمْنَا أَنَّفْتَاتِنَا لَلْفَرْحِ بِرُؤْيَةِ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم. We were so happy to see the blessed face of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. We wanted to break our prayer. Now, there is no other way that if they are praying toward Qibla, if they are praying towards facing the Kaaba, and in Riyadh al-Jannah, and the house is on the left hand side, surely the love of the companions, they must have turned the blessed face in prayer to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Say subhanallah. Are we exceeding the limits by celebrating Milad, whereas the companions would turn their faces in prayer to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Hadith of Sahih Bukhari, this is. Yeah, this is our Aqeedah of Ahlul Sunnah is proven through Sahih Ahadith inside out, and there should be no doubt about it. Unfortunately, unfortunately, due to lack of study, even our own people, the Ahlul Sunnah, due to lack of education, lack of studying Quran and Hadith, under great shoes, due to this reason, we are not strong enough in our own Aqeedah. Now we have this culture of Qadam Borsi in the culture of our Bangladesh and even in Pakistan. I'm Pakistani, even in Pakistan where Dera, Hazif and such other areas, they do Qadam Borsi and people say, what is this? This is shirk, and this is not allowed. Rasulullah's lessons in some ahadith from the Prophet regards to Qadam Borsi. You know, people, we kiss the hands of our shoes. People have a problem with that as well. The Sahaba used to kiss the hands of the Prophet, but not just the hands, they used to kiss the feet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Listen to this hadith, and this is Aqeedah of Imam Bukhari, because Imam Bukhari has recorded this hadith in his Adab al-Mufrad. Hadith is that, عن زارع رضي الله عنه قال لما قدمنا المدينة فجعلنا نتبادر من رواحلنا. زارع رضي الله عنه says that we, as we got to Medina, became of our riding animals. فنقبل يد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We kissed the blessed hands of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then he continues to say, ورجليه. And we kissed the feet of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So there should be no doubt about Qadam Borsi. There's a lot of problems there that people say, this is not allowed to say. Aqeedah of Imam Bukhari. That hadith is that the Sahaba used to kiss the hands and the feet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Imam Bukhari has headed that as a chapter. He did not say kissing the hands and the feet. He said the adab is to kiss the hands and the feet. Indicating that even your elders, even your shuyukh, to do that, this is also part of manners and etiquette. And also I would like to mention that Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim, these are the two great muhaddithin. Imam Muslim, when he went to see Imam Bukhari, this is in Bidayah al-Nihaya by Imam Ibn Kathir. He records this in there, he goes there, when Imam Muslim went to Imam Bukhari, he said, oh Imam Bukhari, oh Sheikh, let me kiss your feet. This is in Bidayah al-Nihaya, Ibn Kathir, and this is by Imam Ibn Kathir, and this is taught widely in Saudi Arabia. In the Gulf area, this is their textbook. They use it in their universities. But it's just that they don't study hard. They don't realize what the reality is. And I'm going to finish off with two or three more hadiths, inshallah, in the next 5 minutes. Now, we all know sajda is haram in the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No one's allowed to prostrate to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But you know what happened to the Sahaba? They had this desire. They had so much love and extreme reverence for the Prophet, they wanted to sajda. Then you should see the animals come. This is hadith of Muslim Ahmad bin Hanbal. And everyone knows this hadith that when the animal would come, the animal would do sajda to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The animal would do sajda to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the companions were shocked and they said, Ya Rasulullah, these people, these animals, they don't have intellect. They don't understand your status. Ya Rasulullah, nahnu ahakku. We are more deserving to do sajda to you. Ya Rasulullah, allow us to prostrate to you. The Prophet said, no, it's not allowed. There's no permission in Ummah. But the fact that the companions desired that, they had that love to do sajda, it shows that they have extreme love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, I have given you many, many examples that the companions, how they showed love. The question is, are we exceeding the limits by showing love for the Prophet, or did the companions, they went too far? And the point to note is that whenever they collected the hair of the Prophet, whenever they collected the blessed saliva of the Prophet, whenever they collected the blessed sweat of the Prophet, whenever they collected the blessed wudu water of the Prophet, did they say, Ya Rasulullah, are we allowed to do this? Did they say, Ya Rasulullah, is this bidah? No, whenever anything was linked to the Rasulullah, anything new, which was bidah, they did it, and Rasulullah did not stop it. What did we learn from that? Because we are told that the Prophet said that follow my sunnah and sunnah of the Khulafa'i Rashidin. And the Prophet said that all my companions are adul, they are just. Whoever you hold on to, you'll be guided. So if the Sahaba did bidah hasana, enjoying love to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then that means we are following the sunnah of the companions of the Prophet to do bidah hasana, to follow Rasulullah, to show love to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam by celebrating bidah. Say subhanallah. But, if people still don't understand this, if people still don't understand this, and they say, you people, Ahlul Sunnah, are still exceeding the limits in the love of Rasulullah, then I give you this hadith. I congratulate you on this day of Milad. The prophet said 1400 years ago, 1435 years ago, he remembered all you people. He remembered all of us. And he said to the companion, he said, this hadith is sahih again, sahih Muslim. He said, "Min ashaddi ummati li hubban nasun yakununa ba'di." And I'm going to stop there and translate this. Prophet said to the companion, "Oh companion, there will be people who will come after me and after you, oh companions, who haven't seen me. And they will have extreme love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ashaddu li hubban." You know the word ishq, the word extreme love. Not love, just love. Extreme love. The Prophet has said that there will be people who will come after you, companions. They will have extreme love. They will have extreme love. They will have extreme love. How? The Prophet has said that, يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ رَعَانِي بِأَهْلِهِ وَمَالِهِ. Just to see one glance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they would want to sacrifice their wealth. They would want to sacrifice their family. They would want to sacrifice their wealth. Just to see one glance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All people of Central Mosque, today we are celebrating Milad. Today we are celebrating the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah remembered us 1400 years ago, and today we are acting upon this. Allah is saying in the Quran, "We have raised for you, O Messenger of Allah, we have raised for you, O my beloved, your dhikr." Allah is saying this, that, "Oh Prophet, I promise you that I am going to raise your remembrance. I am going to raise your remembrance. I am going to raise your dhikr for your sake." And today we can see that every day as it's going by, the love of the Rasulullah is increasing all around the world. And more people are sent to the mosque. There may be many some people who do not celebrate Milad, but think like this, that Allah has chosen you, Lord, to fulfill His promise. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. He has chosen each and every one of you to raise His remembrance, to raise the remembrance of Rasulullah. If someone is not doing this, they have not been given the tawfiq. If you have been given this duty, then fulfill this duty. And inshallah, you will see the result of this in this world. You will see the result of this in your grave. When we see Rasulullah in our grave, and when we recognize Him, and on the day of judgment as well, we will see the result of that. When Rasulullah will come out of his grave, and when he's going to be walking with 70,000 angels around him, and when he will be prostrating to Allah, and he's going to say, "Ya Rab, Ummati, 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 oh my Lord, my Ummah, my Ummah, my Ummah." And Allah is going to say, "Oh beloved, don't take them out. Who do you think is going to take out first? Those who are celebrating Milad, those who are lovers of the Prophet, or those who do not want to know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? I leave the decision to you." And remember, oh brothers and sisters, our Prophet, the Iman, and the love of the Prophet is our Iman. If you do not have the love of the Prophet, then we are destroyed. You can be doing so many actions and good deeds. On the day of judgment, if they are not accepted, then you have lost. But remember, if you have the love of the Prophet, and if you have that in your heart, then on the day of judgment, you will be with the Prophet. And if you are with the Prophet, no angel will have the guts to take you away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I do dua that may Allah Almighty light that candle of love in our hearts of Rasulullah. I do dua that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the company of Rasulullah in this world, in our dreams. May Allah give us the company of Rasulullah in our grave. May Allah give us the company of Rasulullah on the day of judgment, and even in Jannah as well. I do dua that Allah give me the tawfiq as well to act upon what I have said. Wa ma alayna illa al-balagh.